Hey, we're going to talk about how to price your hot dogs today. Give me just a couple seconds. I'm going to get some notes ready here real quick. And I didn't realize it was almost 10 when I got started, but I want to go through this with you. Yesterday we were doing a video and here on the Facebook Live, and someone asked the question about pricing their hot dogs. And I've got that in the training. It's in my course book, Hot Dogs Saved My Life. But I wanted to go through the basics of figuring out your pricing, because he brought up a good point. You know, he had discovered, one person emailed yesterday that he had discovered that the most popular dog was this Nathan's dog, and the way he's got it priced out, he'd end up having to sell it at a pretty high price. And I said, well, you know, you could serve lobster and steak. Everybody pretty much loves that, but not everybody can afford that. So what you have to do is weigh the two off of each other. And I'm going to go through that with you real quick. And let me grab something here. May need to clean up some of this. Hopefully you can see this okay. Okay. I'm making sure you can see. Let's see. I'm gonna move this camera around a bit. Okay, so when you're pricing your products, and this goes for hot dogs. Good morning, Jose. Good morning, David. Alpha Dogs. Lisa here. They took the huge leap and officially opened their business. I'm gonna post this up real quick and show y'all. This is cool. Lisa, congratulations. Coastal Dogs and Catering. I love it. Scott, welcome to the show. Tony, Anthony, welcome to the show. In fact, Anthony helped me yesterday on the join. In fact, I'm going to put a link up here if you want to. This link works for somebody. Some people, it doesn't work for others. I'm going to put up a link if you want to join me here after I get through this part. You can click that link and we can test it out some more to see if it's going to work right. But on to the show. I want to go over the pricing, because you can price yourself out of the market, but you can also underprice yourself and leave what they call leaving money on the table. And you don't want to leave money on the table, but you also want to offer something that they feel like they got a good deal. Now, there's some variables in here. You know, doing fairs and festivals, you got different types of costs, different types of risk, and you might charge, well, you should be charging more. I know some vendors that charge, you know, a normal hot dog, they may charge $3 for, but they're charging $8 for it at a big event or a fair because of what they're paying and their risk. Risk goes way up at events because you have stock and you have more invested in that event. But just the average cart, okay, just the average cart, and I want to go over this first. The first one is product cost, and I'm going to put that as number one here, and I'll write it here, product cost. Now, product cost is your first determinant in what you decide to price your menu at, your menu items. Because if you pay $3 for your hot dog, you can't sell it for two, not for very long, okay? You'll need a bigger Wells Fargo truck to pull up and take money away from you and give to other people if you do it that way. So don't. That should be obvious to everyone, but your product costs, let's say you like the gentleman that emailed me yesterday, and let's say you have an 80 cents, okay, 80 cent cost. And when I do my costs out, and if you'll remember, I did a video on this last week on costing everything out and making sure you're including everything from the foil wrappers to the napkins, to the ice, to the propane, to your time, everything. You'll want to know everything, okay? You don't just look at the hot dog itself and go, well, I paid 18 cents for the dog. Well, you got a bun, you got condiments, you got a wrapper, you got a napkin, you got a bag possibly, you got a foil, you got other stuff, you got other products to go with it. You had LP gas to heat the water. You have costs involved, and that's what I showed you last week. If you missed that, you can go to learnhotdogs.com, and it's on that page. Figuring out your cost. But let's say your total cost is 80 cent. Well, not gonna work well at a dollar to sell at a dollar. This would have to be closer to $2, right? But realistically, you'd probably want it at $3. Now, I do even numbers. I don't use, when I say even numbers, whole dollar increments. I don't use 50 cent, 325 or whatever. I don't do that because I do not like carrying change and handing out change. It slows you down. If you're a vendor that's busy, it will slow you down, period. No way to get around it. If you've got extra monies that you have to make change with, it slows you down. But if your smallest denominator is one, it's really easy. Okay? $1 bills. So everything I do is in $1 increments, basically. So it may be a $6 value meal. But so I like to go up to the next price of $3. Okay? That way, when I combine my meal, which is maybe two hot dogs, a drink, and chips, that I can be, that would normally be eight, I can be at seven, right? Because I didn't hurt myself. I basically sold my dogs at $2.50 each instead of $3 each. That is your best bet there with product cost. But what if $3, you're in, let me give you an example. What if you're in one of the poor counties, like in Alabama? There's some poor, really poor counties. West Virginia, there's some very, very poor counties. Kentucky, Eastern Kentucky has some really rough places that they really, I mean, most of the residents are on some type of food program, food assistance program. Well, are there vendors there making it? Yes, we've got a video and a picture and did an interview with a gentleman that works there, and he does good there. But he had to, he couldn't sell $3 hot dogs. Heck, he had trouble selling $2 hot dogs. He went with a dollar hot dog, but he's selling a very inexpensive hot dog. His hot dog's only costing him, I think, 12 cents, plus his peripheral costs. So that's where you have to look at what your market can bear. So you have your product cost to consider, and your second one is your market area. So if you're in Los Angeles County, or maybe you're in Portland, Oregon, or Seattle, Washington, or even places like Knoxville, Tennessee, next to me, you can command more money. Jason Brown, a friend of mine, and you've heard him on the show of Love Food Trucks, has told me, he told me for years, Ben, you need to raise your prices. I was still selling hot dogs at $2 each, a $5 value meal, right? So I was doing $2 each. He goes, go to $3. No, but they aren't going to blink. I'm going, they're probably going to blink. Well, they didn't. Went to $3, they didn't blink. And it's because I include the condiments at $2. I also included them at $3. It didn't change anything. No, my sales didn't drop. But I will tell you, it's hard to go up in prices when you have regulars. So when you're first starting to price, always start higher. Okay, and then you can always come down. It's really hard to go up. I did it, but I caught some flack for it. I caught some people that were going, man, Ben, why'd you raise your price? You used to be $2 for the same dog. Now you're $3. And I'm going, well, prices went up on the meat and, my neighbor's chickens having puppies and I had to raise the price. But that's the start higher, you'll come out ahead. And there's hot dogs out here. You can go get some nice hot dogs. I'm going to erase this real quick, okay? And just part of this. But let's say you're, in fact, you know what? I'm going to erase all of this so I can write more. But if you are, if you're doing a value meal, consider that cost. But there's hot dogs out there that you can pay over a dollar for, okay? This is real cost, okay? $1.21 cost for a hot dog. And that's before you added your condiments and stuff. So let's say you figure safe and you had 30 cent to cover your peripherals. Now you're at $1.51, okay, per hot dog. Well, I would want to sell that dog for $4 or $5, and you may be able to get it. You're in Pennsylvania in the Pocono Mountains. You can probably sell them for $8. my point is your market area has a lot to do with that. So don't go with what you think is the best tasting dog all the time. I teach you to do a taste test. But if you're testing out the most expensive hot dogs, you can bet the winner's going to be the most. It's like me giving you plain donuts and then cream stuffed Boston cream donuts. More than likely, you're going to pick the Boston cream or the jelly filled on the taste test. So when you run your taste test, and yes, there are better products, you know, Boar's Head and Nathan's and Vienna, but Nathan's has knockoff, you know, not knockoff brands, but private labeled brands where you can get them for a third the price. So consider that when you're doing this. My biggest suggestion would go all beef and make it your hot dog. Make it yours by changing the water flavor if you're boiling them or steaming them. Add the beer, add the bouillon, or add whatever you want to add to it so that you create your own flavor dog, and then it's yours. It's Hillbilly Hot Dogs. It's not Nathan's. Well, now they know, oh, I got to go get a Hillbilly Hot Dog because those are the best. Well, you've made it your own. That's what I'm telling you about doing this is consider your costs. You could have this high cost, and it may be popular in your food test, but if you live in West Virginia, odds are you're not going to sell any, okay? Because you're going to have to sell this for $4 to $5 or $3 to $4, still not going to sell any at $3, not in some of those towns in West Virginia. You'd be lucky if you ever sold one. So you want a hot dog, the average right now, most people are at about $2 each, okay? A lot have been going to three each, but they've added their condiments, where before they were taking their condiments, it was plus condiments. Now they're adding the condiments at three. Well, they only have a real true cost maybe of 22 cent, but they're making an extra 78 cent by doing it that way per dog. And I know these numbers don't sound like much when you think about it like that, in terms like that, they don't 78 cent. But when you talk about 200 hot dogs in a day, okay, or 100 hot dogs in a day, just say 100 hot dogs. But my goal always was 200 hot dogs a day because that was roughly 100 customers because I did a value meal. So you want to leave yourself room in your pricing to create a value meal and at the same time have it in line, your final price in line with what your market can bear. Okay. I'd much rather you though try to be higher at first. When you're starting out, you can always go down to two, but it's hard to go up. You can go up, it's just harder. Here's something when I'm costing out too, and this may help you a little bit when you're trying to figure out your costs. I like to triple my real cost. Now, remember, I said if you miss this, I know we've got new people that have joined us. If you missed it, go to learnhotdogs.com, and it's free. I did the video last week that gives you your true cost, okay? How to figure those real costs on everything, your peripherals and everything. But let's say your true cost, I'm going to make up one, 43 cent, okay, is my true cost of a hot dog with condiments, okay, with my selection of condiments, chili, cheese, onions, whatever, right? Maybe even bacon bits. My true cost is 43 cents. That's total. Now, I like to triple this number of my true cost. So I'll do a 3X on that, and that's going to put me at about $1.50. Well, I don't want to sell hot dogs at $1.50, but I could. Now, follow me here, and I'll show you what I do. So I would sell this hot dog at $2 each, okay? But I'd have a value meal, which put me two dogs, chips, and a drink, okay? Which if you added that up, this one's $1, this one's $1. They got two dogs here, so that's $4, right? So we got $6 in this value meal, right? Well, I'd sell that value meal at $5. I'm saving them a dollar by going with the value meal, and I have room to do it because I could sell these dogs at 150 and still maintain my 3x multiple. I like the 3x multiple. Now, some vendors have an 8x multiple, a 10x multiple. It depends on your market area. So there is no cut and dry rule with it. There is none. But you want to know your cost, your true cost, and you want to at least, at a minimum, triple that number. Okay? I like to triple it. I know some vendors that double this number. They may be at $1.43 true cost. Okay? They double that number, and they're selling theirs at $3 each. Right? So you could double, but that doesn't leave you enough room for your meal deals and stuff. And some people don't like the meal deal idea. I do. I taught McDonald's how to do it, and I figure it's a good plan. Not really, but sounded good, didn't it? So that's how I would price that. I'm going to get some of your questions real quick. If you have questions on here, I'm going to sit back down and see if I can help you out with anything. I know I've had a lot of people commenting and stuff, and I'm going to go through this real quick with you. Let me move my camera down a little bit. Let's see. That way you can see my pretty mug. All right. So here we go. Now let's see. Okay. I wanted to, again, congratulate Lisa. That's freaking awesome that y'all got that going. I wish you well. I hope you'll keep in touch and let us know. Tony says, good morning to everybody. Josh Black says, good morning. Good morning all. Greg. Now, Ken, catering for you is in. Scott, hey, I'll bring you a fifth of Pappy Van Winkle bourbon from Kentucky when I come down to pick up my card. I freaking love it, Scott. I love me some bourbon. Ben Dean says, hey to Ken. Let's see. Scott Wells getting ready to start slinging dogs for a living. Love it, Scott. Third grade education is what I have. You and me both, and I struggled with that grade. Greg Crafton, good morning, Ozarks, where I am. 30% food cost is restaurant national average. Does this apply to hot dog business as well? Great question, Jose. This is a good question. Okay. This is basically what I just showed you. Remember the 3x multiple? It's basically that. Your food cost, but see, I don't use just my food cost. I include all my cost. My gas, my ice, my everything is in all that cost. And I try to triple that number. If it was just food costs, let's say the hot dog cost you, let's say you're getting a decent hot dog for 22 cents. Okay. I think it's on page 77 or something. Let me pull this up for you real quick. Okay. So page 77 of Hot Dog Saved My Life. Hot Dog Sam's Club right now, 8 to 1s. This means 8 dogs to a pound, and a 10 pound box of those is roughly $19. It's $18.82. It was currently at this time. The other day they had them at $17 and something, but or 24 cent each. So there's your food cost, right? Plus your bun. Well, your bun is going to be about 11 cents. So now you're at 35 cent based on this, right? Then you got relish, 3 cents a serving, and onions about a penny a serving, ketchup about 2 cents a serving, mustard. I broke it all down for you, but let's say after you're done with this, you're at about 45 cent, right? If you did a multiple of 3 on that, you'd be at $1.50. But I like to use a real number, which includes my gas, my propane, my napkins, my fuel, my everything. Okay. Well, once you do that, you end up maybe being closer to 70 cent or 65 cent for the same hot dog, right? But you're actually including real costs now. Something that you know is accurate. So take 65 cent and triple it. Now you're at about $1.95, right? So you're still $2. You're still covering your basis. But that's why Jason advised me. Heck, I helped Jason get started in this business, and he's advised me more than anybody I can imagine. But he said, Ben, you need to be at $3. Be at $3. Well, I went to $3, and I told you it was a little bit of a struggle. But it didn't hurt my market share at all. It didn't hurt business at all. Customers still kept coming, still kept coming, still kept coming, because $3 wasn't bad for what I gave them. I gave them one, an experience, And that's part of it too. I'm going to talk about that later today, I believe. I'm going to be back on here later. Just talking about your attitude, your general freaking attitude on the card. And we'll go over that. But I appreciate the question. I think it was a good question. I appreciate you joining in. Bubba's here. Thanks for Bubba for being here. Denny, the dog from Chesterfield, Michigan. Dennis, thanks for being here. Cheryl, do you ever offer a regular size and also a jumbo dog? Abso-freaking-lutely. But let me tell you, if you don't have this book, you need to get it. Hot Dog Saved My Life. But you don't have to get it. I've got all the information free for you at learnhotdogs.com. So learnhotdogs.com, you'll see that I cover this. You always want to go with what sells the best. Go to the grocery store, look at the size that sells the best. It's an 8-to-1 hot dog. But it's always good to have something else. I didn't do good with a jumbo dog, but I did real good with a big sausage. Okay? I had a sausage, and it was just a smoked sausage. That's it. Put it in the same water. I put my, not the same pan with the hot dogs, but the same water flavoring, right? And I would pull those out, usually split them long ways when they'd order them, because back then it was $3. Now they're $4, what I sell them for. Split them long ways, lay them up on my grill on my big dog, and it would char them up just a little bit. All that is for is presentation. It really doesn't change the flavor, okay, unless you really, really cooked it there, and I didn't. And throw it in the bun, throw stuff on there. It smokes up. It's pretty. It sounds good, smells good, looks good, tastes good, and costs good. And hand those out. I always say to do that. But I will warn you, you don't want to go over your head. You might have an area where you have lots of tourists or something, and you could sell tofu dogs, and you could sell footlongs, and you start carrying too much stuff, you'll end up costing yourself out of business, because what ends up happening is you end up with more waste, more risk. That's why I was saying in the beginning of this, you have more risk when you put out money for an event because you've bought more. Same goes for having more inventory or more types of inventory. It's more headache. And so in the beginning, I'd say at the max, two different dogs or a dog and a sausage, max, when you start out. And you may continue that way. I still do. I still, when I go out, two. That's it. No reason for me to do more. So I should have had that up there. Thanks for the question, Cheryl. That was a good question. Francisco says, hey. Hey, Francisco. Morales. Josh Schlong, Sloppy Dogs, checking in from Maryland. Glad you're here. Corinthia Marjorie, how would you price condiments? I include my condiments in my price of my hot dog. I do not charge extra. Here's when I do. I have a couple exceptions. Bacon jam. If you don't know what that is, search it at learnhotdogs.com and you'll, holy cow. And my Coke onion recipe. Search it too. I've got a video of me making that as well. And with the recipe. It's real hard. It's Coke and onions. And so, those two things cost me more time and more effort, and I don't want to price my dogs on my menu, because not everybody gets that, in at a price enough to cover that. At $3, it already would, but I can make a dollar more by piling it on, and usually it's the people that get the sausage. They want a big clump of those Coke onions, right? So I'd pile them up on there. Well, I figure that I have a cost in that, which I know I do, down to the penny, right? I know exactly what it costs me for that big clump of onions. So what I do is charge a dollar extra. But as far as, oh, they want extra mustard, oh, they want chili and cheese, some people do charge for chili and cheese extra. It's not a bad thing to do. I'm just telling you, I wanted my life simpler. I don't like a lot of upsells, like when you go to the tire shop and they got 900 upsells. Oh, you want air in the tires? Well, that's going to be $2 extra. Oh, you want us to keep the old tires? That's $1.50 extra a tire. I mean, all these little upsells just piss me off. So customers feel that way too. They want to know when they go to Burger King and get a Whopper, you're not going to charge them extra because they got extra mustard. It's your way right away. I like that mentality. I don't worry about it. Okay. I have done this even. I've had people balk and go, how much are the Coke onions? And I'll go $1. And they'll go, oh, I ain't paying $1 for onions. And I'll go, I tell you what, I'm going to give them to you. Okay. And if you don't like them, if you don't think it's worth, okay, now I'm still charging them, but I'm going to put them on here for you. Charge you a dollar. If you don't think it's worth every penny of that extra dollar you paid, I'll give you your whole meal free. The whole meal. Well, people take you up on that in a heartbeat. Plus, most people are not going to go just to screw you. They're not going to go, well, I didn't like it after they ate it. Okay. I never worried about that. I had a couple people, I'd go, I'll guarantee it. And I've had a couple people try to scam me and go, yeah, I didn't like any of that. Well, where's the rest of the hot dogs? Well, we ate them. I mean, we still ate them. We didn't like them, but we ate them. We sacrificed. And I'm going, yeah, BS. But it didn't matter to me. I'd go, here's your money back. Hope you have a good day. And I move on because all of that spreads goodwill. I wouldn't get wrapped up, Corinthia, in the price of trying to do the add-ons. Try to put all your pricing, like I was showing, into that one price. Great show, Ben. Thanks for teaching. You're welcome, Ken. I appreciate the kind words. So you sell a drink and chips for a dollar each regular price? Yes. My drink is a dollar. My chips are a dollar. And my chips are usually about a 3/4 ounce bag or the 1 ounce bag. Because if you buy from Sam's Club, I buy those variety bags from Sam's Club. Let me give you that real quick and I'll tell you the exact number, Josh. The chips, let's see. Chips, Frito-Lay assorted box. Sam's Club, 50 ounce. It says 51 ounce bags in some of them, but some of them I've noticed they'll have a 3/4 ounce bag. And then they'll have an ounce and a half bag of a different type in that assortment. The bag, it's $11.22. Okay. It may be a little less now or a little more now. It fluctuates at Sam's. That's 22 cent a bag, right? I charge a dollar for it. Some people use the big 3 ounce bags, the bigger snack pack bags, and they charge more for them. I don't. The little bags, I end up, some people go, yeah, give me the Frito-Lays and give me the barbecue. They'll want 2 bags and they just pay an extra dollar. And nobody ever says anything about that. It's kind of like your Cokes. You might be paying 18 cent this week for them or 24 cent next week for them. I charge a dollar. Either way, it's a dollar. Water is about 9 cent and I charge a dollar. Water bottles. Hey, Ben, what's up, Tony, with Big T's Hot Dogs coming soon in Jacksonville, Florida. I know, Tony, I'm excited and I can't wait to see how you do in Jacksonville. Jacksonville's a beautiful place. I actually used to work rescue there. I even worked at Methodist Hospital over by University Hospital in the ER once. Well, for about 2 years. Mark Payne, eye level link, product copy of Chili Man seasoning pack. Is this chili you talked about using? I don't see 10 cans on the side. Eye level link product copy of Chili Man. No, it's not a seasoning mix. Chili Man's is the actual chili. Okay. It's Chili Man's chili. It's already in. It's ready. It's not a mix. It's ready to go. Serve it right out of the can. It's pre-cooked. It's ready. Joseph says very educational from the Philippines. Mark, if you need to email me, I'll send you a link to Chili Man's. Tim, and I'm glad you're here from the Philippines. That's cool as crap. Looking to get out of the car business into the dog business. I'm learning a lot from you. Tim Van Lee. I talked to a gentleman that was he was a used car salesman yesterday. That's awesome. Cheryl says, thank you. Mountain Dew and onions. Yes, you can do the Mountain Dew and onions too. In fact, Mountain Dew has the highest rate of sugar, so it caramelizes nicely. I just like that charred, that more caramel color that's in a cola. Bourbon and onions. I think it would really sell good. Absolutely. In fact, I may be doing it today. I'm going to do a little video. I finally found those freaking bourbon brown sugar hot or sausages, and I'm going to be cooking some of those up today. I'll try to put it on my Instagram and my Facebook here. Let's see. 2 hot dogs, chips, and soda, $5. That's what I've seen in most hot dog stands. Should you buy bulk to offset cost? Should you buy? Yes, absolutely. But only when you can afford to. Jose, Don't go out thinking, I'm going to do this now. I'm going to buy in bulk from the get-go. If it straps you for cash, it ain't worth the risk. I mean, the first 2 days, it may have been three days, that I was working my cart, I couldn't afford to buy in bulk. I couldn't even buy enough hot dogs for 1 day from the grocery store. So I was going in the grocery store buying. Well, we started with 2 packs of dogs. I can tell you that. We started with 2 packs of dogs. That's what, I think it was 16 dogs, right? 16 dogs. They were 8-to-1s. I think Oscar Mayer or something. And put them in my boiling water and did my little thing. And then turned around and see, even back then I wasn't seasoning my water. Didn't know about that. I hadn't figured out that the water was taking the flavor out of the dog. So later I learned to season the water. So, or pre-saturated is what I call it. So anyway, my wife was running back and forth to the store that first day and the second day. And I think part of the third day, because we couldn't afford to buy in bulk. Only buy in bulk when you can afford to and you have the storage for it, and look at the shelf life of it. Hot dogs have a pretty good shelf life, so don't worry. But you can freeze them, put them in a deep freezer. You can buy a chest freezer pretty cheap, usually $150-$200 on Craigslist, sometimes cheaper than that. Put them in the deep freezer, pull them out the day before, let them be thawing. If you're going to, if you know you're going to, once you figure out your numbers and you know, hey, I'm going to go through 220 dogs I average a day, or I average 114 dogs a day, whatever it is. Right? You pull them out, let them be thawing. That way, when you get to your cart, you can dump them in the water, but they don't even have to be thawed. I show you how to do that straight from freezer to water, and 7 minutes, you got dogs. Let's see. Thanks for the well wishes, Ben. You have been our inspiration and driving force behind making our dreams. You're going to make me blush, Lisa. Quit. Stop. I appreciate the kind words, though. I hope y'all enjoyed this. I did, and I hope that you got some value from this information. I know I keep pointing at my board, but I erased most everything because I write big, but I was trying to write where y'all could see it. I hope you enjoyed it. If y'all have more questions, post them up, and I'm going to start doing mini segments, okay, every day, showing different aspects. That way, we don't have a show with 900 lessons in it. I got individual shows. Now, like today, we covered some other stuff, right? But that's just bonus material. It's bonus. You get this for free, and then you get this as a bonus for free. So it's just how it worked out. But I love it. I'm glad y'all participate. I hope y'all have a wonderful day. I'll be back today. I'm going to do those sausages today, I believe. But I know I'm going to also be back talking about your attitude. I just about knocked off my glasses. Attitude on the cart. I'm going to tell you what you can do to make more money just by being there, and how to do that. Just by being there, how you'll make more money with the right attitude. So we'll get to that. Take care, Francisco. Thank y'all for being here. I appreciate all of you. Love you a ton, and I wish only the best for you. I've enjoyed this, and I'll talk to y'all a little later today.